Mayor, Council, the instead of going through the presentation, as I said earlier, when you pass the budget each year, I'm to bring you up update on how we're doing in the current fiscal year. So I'll just do three quick ones. One, I would call it green, green, yellow. So in terms of where we ended the last fiscal year, June 30, 2014, on a preliminary basis, when we came to council at the retreat in September, on a preliminary basis, we were about $2 million to the good. That's just the city's general fund. Now that we closed the books and you had the presentation the last time that the council met here, we actually ended the year at $4 million to the good. So I'd call that from where we've been, FY 2014, that's good. In September, council said, let's take the $2 million and let's apply $1 million to the economic downturn reserve and $1 million to the risk management reserve. So you have a floor of $3 million for each one of them and a ceiling of $5 million. By putting $1 million in each one of them, you're now at $4 million in both of those reserves. You have a third pot, which is our 5% reserve, and the council has always been able to be at that 5% reserve. So what does that mean for the two additional $1 million? As Brian said, it seems like everybody should be rallying around the Senate's budget as it relates to the aid to locality cut being restored, but that's FY16. In FY15, the state already took away the $1.4 million from Norfolk when it comes to the aid to locality cut. So, and on top of that, we lost about $450,000 related to HB 599 funds, as Brian had mentioned. So together, that's almost a $2 million hit. And my recommendation to the council is, could we use that remaining $2 million to offset those cuts? Because the way the state would divvy those up, it would hurt the sheriff's office, it would hurt police, it would hurt human services and other constitutional officers. So that's where we ended in FY14. FY15, the mid-year report is that revenue, we're tracking about 0.5% below what our estimate is. But on the expenditure side, we're also tracking about 0.5%, 2% less. So where we are mid-year is where we are mid-year is not in bad shape. In terms of, so I have to call that green too. So in terms of the FY16 budget back in September, we talked about having this $9 million gap in 16. Right now, there are a series of estimates, revisions, departments coming through with plans, and I won't even call them reduction plans, just re-engineering, doing things better. We have that cut in half, maybe closer to $3 to $4 million. So going into the next couple of months before we present a budget to the council, what we have to deal with is about a $3 to $4 million gap. And I will say that we'll take that any day. Years and years ago, we were talking $20 million gaps and things of that nature. So that is what typically is a 30-minute discussion, which I would say that, again, FY14 ended on a positive note. FY15, we're tracking. And FY16, we're very confident that we're going to present to you a structurally balanced budget in the next couple of months.
You didn't cover schools.
Schools, I'm sorry, good point. Okay, schools, in terms of where they ended for FY14, they ended with about $3.4 million to the good. So the recommendation is to allow the school system to use that FY14 surplus to help balance their FY16 gap.
We've always done that. We want them to be frugal with their money so they get the benefit of it. So, Marcus, the additional use of the $2 million is, I mean, that seems perfectly appropriate to me. And you never let us spend it anyway, so you might as well just, if we had said no, they would have gone away some way, so we don't know that. So, anyway, so, okay.
Okay.